and welcome to Crowforest Reviews. Last time I talked about Transformers, but this time... Oh wait, sorry, I need to do this right. Previously on Crowforest Reviews...
Let's talk about Transformers.
And now the conclusion. So Transformers was surprisingly awesome given the admittedly pretty lame premise, but can My Little Pony hold up with what is debatably an even lamer premise? Let's find out. So we start out with some backstory briefly outlining the history and mythology of the land of Equestria, narrated to us by our protagonist Twilight Sparkle, who is deep in her magical studies. So deep, in fact, that she's only just then getting to what proves to be the single most famous story in all of Equestrian history. Weird. Anyway, plot hiccups aside, Twilight is walking home when she runs into some friends of hers, and they invite her to a party that another friend is throwing. Now, of course, in previous generations of My Little Pony, they were all about the parties and the friends and the socializing. But this isn't previous generations. Twilight declines the invitation in a gesture that I'm sure will not come back to bite her in the flank in season 5. So what does Twilight have to do that's so important that she can't go to her friend's party? Why, study, of course! And before you start thinking she's just a good student who puts studies first, her own teacher outright forbids her from doing any more homework and tells her to go make some friends. That's pretty bad. Even by my standards. But Twilight is determined to keep reading her books, even if she now has to do it in between her new, far more irksome tasks of making friends. She has become obsessed with some ancient powerful artifacts known as the Elements of Harmony, and in researching them has stumbled across a text outlining the escape and rise of a mysterious and sinister figure known as Nightmare Moon. But her studies are cut short by all those pesky friend-making nuisances that were mandated by her teacher, who just happens to be the ruler of the land, so her word is kind of law. So who does she meet first? Why, Pinkie Pie, of course! The insane spaz attack on steroids. Naturally, this does nothing to brighten Twilight's outlook on friend-making. Then she meets Applejack.
I'm here, come.
Why? I'd say they're already part of the family.
Rainbow Dash.
I can't wait to hang out some more.
Rarity.
We are gonna be the best of friends, you and I.
Fluttershy.
Well, what do you want to know?
Absolutely everything.
And it's Pinkie Pie again.
Surprise! Hi, I'm Pinkie Pie, and I threw this party just for you. Were you surprised? Were you?
Yes, thank you, Pinkie. I think we get the point.
Libraries are supposed to be quiet.
Well, that's silly. What kind of welcome party would this be if it were quiet? I mean, duh. Boring. You see, I saw you when you first got here, remember? You were all hello, and I was all, remember? You see, I never saw you before, and if I never saw you before, that meant you're new. Because I know every pony, and I mean every pony in Ponydom.
Yes, thank you, Pinkie. That will do.
And if you're new, it meant you hadn't met anyone yet. And if you haven't met anyone yet, you must not have any friends. And if you don't have any friends, then you must be lonely. And that made me so sad, and I had an idea. And that's why I went, I just threw a great big ginormous super duper spectacular welcome party and invite everyone in Ponyville. See?
Pinkie, for Celestia's sake, this clip has gone on far too long.
And now you have lots and lots of friends.
Are you all right, Sugar Cube?
Thank you, Twilight, for expressing how we're all feeling.
All the ponies in this town are crazy!
Anyway, Twilight finally manages to escape from the party, but by that time it's already too late. Nightmare Moon returns, causing every pony to tremble in fear, thus ending part one. Hey, wait a minute, why are the Cutie Mark Crusaders huddled together? They don't even meet until episode 12. So, after a little mood whiplash caused by the show's upbeat opening theme song following the previously on, episode 2 begins proper with the five ponies Twilight met earlier breaking into Twilight's house to provide some very unsubtle foreshadowing. So they all go off into the spooky forest, don't ask, they just do, where they have all kinds of wacky adventures that perfectly showcase all of their respective talents. Wow, how dramatically convenient! And also, some of their solutions are just weird. When they come across a demon tree, which is apparently a thing in that world, how do they try to defeat it? With a song number, of course. Works! But demon trees aren't the only thing they have to deal with. Nightmare Moon has set up tons of obstacles for them to face, including knocking them off a cliff, sending a charging manticore after them, the aforementioned demon trees, upsetting a gay sea serpent into a homicidal rage, and finally putting some spooky mist at the end of a fallen bridge. Though, to be fair, the actual fallen bridge wasn't her fault. That was caused by Dr. Whooves. Because he's an idiot. So after overcoming all of the aforementioned obstacles, the six ponies finally make it to their destination, the location of the Elements of Harmony, where they have their final showdown with Nightmare Moon. As with my Transformers review, I won't go into too much detail about the climax, so I'll just jump right into the other elements of the show. First off, the animation is great. I realize that much like with Transformers Prime, the style isn't for everyone, but I just love the big, expressive, anime-esque eyes, the detailed backgrounds, and of course, the rainbow power. But like I said before, animation is not the most important element. You can have something with great animation that is still a terrible product. See the Lorax. Actually, no, don't. The Lorax sucked. But fortunately, such is not the case here, as both the story and the characters are done really well, which is quite an accomplishment considering that the premise would be really easy to screw up. But I still haven't answered the big question. Which show is better? I personally enjoyed My Little Pony a little bit more, but I would hesitate to say that it's better. Do you prefer fantasy or science fiction? Do you prefer down-to-earth relatable characters or battle-hardened warriors? And now I'm rambling. Anyway, they're both really good shows coming from not much of a premise, and I would gladly give a recommendation to both of them.
Yay!
But of course, there's another question that I know that many of you are wondering. How did I get into My Little Pony in the first place? Well, I was at the Dallas Comic Con in 2012, and I went to John DeLancey's panel. And he had some very interesting things to say on the subject that changed my view completely.
It's not My Little Pony, it is Friendship is Magic. And it purports, interestingly enough, a better future. And I want to invite you, who are Trek fans, to embrace Friendship is Magic fans, because I discovered that we all have a lot in common. So, here.
Hopefully that answered all of your questions. Anyway, until next time, here's your kid-friendly clip of the day.
Remember this day, little ponies, for it was your last. From this moment forth, the night will last forever.
Thank you.